Are you having trouble getting your podcast recognized by your audience? Well, guess what? We're going to help you fix that right now. Here we go. Hey, what's up, everybody? Brian Fitton here with Go Rogue X. We believe in doing marketing differently. And today we're going to jump into how to get your podcast recognized by more people in your audience. First thing you have to do is submit your podcast to all of the platforms. So there's different apps out there like Anchor that you can obviously, it'll do a lot of that for you. Or if you're using a hosting service like Transistor.fm or Buzzsprout, both two I really recommend, or even Libsyn. There are sometimes ways in that podcast feed that you can actually say, hey, submit this to Spotify for me. But that's a very, very important because you want to make sure that your podcast is being able to be found by everybody who is looking for it. So make sure that you go out to Google, Stitcher. We'll put a whole list of links in the comments below in the description. But make sure that you're doing that to get it out to every single person that you can because you never know where they're listening. So you want to make sure to be where they are. Second thing is be consistent. You have to be consistent. So make sure that when you're launching your episode every single week, make sure it's on the exact same time. So that way you can build that trust with your audience, because if they love your show and they're anticipating it and ready for it to come out, if you say, hey, Thursday mornings, that's when we launch a podcast, you need to make sure that you're there every single week because a lot of people are waiting for it. You miss a week or two, you're going to lose a lot of that trust, and people are investing into your podcast and into your content. So make sure you're consistent every single time. Show up, make sure you're there. So another way to make sure that your audience sees your content is to repurpose your podcast. So us here at Go Rogue X, that's what we love to do. We love to take one piece of pillar content and chop it up like crazy and make sure it's formatted correctly for Instagram, IGTV, make sure that for YouTube it's set in this correct way, as well as in the feed for Instagram or LinkedIn, Facebook, whatever that looks like. Stories is different than what it looks like on an Instagram feed. You know, your 4x5, it has to be set up correctly, but repurpose all of your content as much as possible because you want to make sure that wherever your audience is, you're there. Just like we talked about with making sure it's on all your feeds and all the correct platforms, make sure you're doing that too with your social media content. You want to make sure to impact those people wherever they are. All right, so if you're an interview show, these are for all my interviewers out there, make sure that you're getting somebody who's interesting. Make sure you're not just asking your buddy down the street to jump on your podcast because they might be pretty boring. You never know. So make sure you're getting interesting people. Obviously, the bigger the name, that's going to help establish some credibility. May not obviously get more download numbers, but you never know what one show could actually take off. So make sure that you're getting interesting people on your show. Bigger names are obviously better, but you know what? Even if they have a smaller following, they might be a better interview for you. So make sure that you're interviewing people who you know that your audience is going to interact with and get value from as well. Another thing that we like to do is to make sure our guests shares the episode itself. So if we're interviewing somebody, we want to make it super easy for them to actually be able to share that episode. So we usually send out an email and say, hey, you're on our show. We appreciate you so much. Here are all the links, basically, to be able to share that content out. We're making additional content. We're repurposing that. We tag them. We make it easy for them. So that way, if it shows up in their story, they can just hit share to my own story. And that helps promote that episode and using their following, because a lot of times their followers, they want to know exactly what they're doing. And so you want to make sure to make it easy for them to be able to share that content. And that'll help, obviously, get you in front of new audiences as well. And speaking of new audiences, you want to be a guest on other people's shows. It makes it so, I mean, I can't even tell you the amount of people I have found just because they are on different podcasts and they're actually the guest or an expert interview on another podcast. And all of a sudden I'm like, you know what? I want to find out more about this person. And then that kind of leads me down a trail to figure out, oh, hey, they actually have good content. And all of a sudden I'm becoming a fan of theirs, even though it wasn't, the original intent was not for me to do that, but it's obviously a great way to expose yourself to new audiences. And so I would highly recommend that. Try to jump into somebody else's podcast, especially if it's in some of the same industry, some of the same area, and you can offer value to that audience. Make sure to get out there and promote yourself through being a guest on somebody else's show. Live recordings. Oh, live recordings. Hey, we're live. Do it live. Oh gosh, yeah, that's don't go look that up. Do not type that back into YouTube of Do It Live. It is a crazy video of Bill O'Reilly. Anyway, all right, I'm on a tangent, but go live. Make sure that you guys are doing it live. Make sure that you're all your content, especially if you're doing a podcast or some type of Facebook live show. Obviously, if it's live, it's going to be live. But if you're doing a podcast, do it live. It actually generates a lot of interest because you can kind of see behind the scenes. People love to see what's going on behind the scenes. So make sure you do a live session, either even with your phone, with Instagram TV. Production may not be there. You may not be able to tie your mic into your phone and it all sound great, but it shows some behind the scenes, and that'll obviously get way more exposure for your audience to be able to actually see what you're doing and be able to consume your content and get that value from you as well. All right, I know we've covered a ton of stuff today, but make sure, this is one of the last things I want to tell you, make sure you're involved in your community, right? Your audience is there. So specifically around Facebook groups, I would say jump into Facebook groups that have something to do with what your podcast is about. And I'm not telling you, do not do this. I swear I will hunt you down if you do this. If you just go in there and promote your show, which if you're watching this, you obviously want to do it differently, but do not go in and just promote your show. Go in, answer questions, become a leader in that specific Facebook group. So that way people can actually look at you and say, oh, hey, this person knows what they're talking about. They're offering value. And a lot of times they will find your podcast through that avenue of you just being a useful resource for them. That is a great way to grow your audience and your exposure for your podcast. So now that you know how to get your podcast recognized by your audience, go do it. Keep creating. Make sure you drop your show link in the comments below, because we'd love to interact with you. We'd love to hear what you're creating and help promote you as well. If you have any ideas or questions or things you want to learn about, we want to make sure that we're here to help you with that. So put those in the comments as well. Let's keep interacting. And until next week, we'll see you later.